We live our lives in stories. And we clash because our stories diverge, because I have one story of who you ought to be. You have a different story of who you ought to be. So, Dean Davis, Abby, you guys can help me with this. The creation story, the cosmology of the Dinka in South Sudan is a beautiful cosmology, right? God first created Dinka. The tallest, they were the closest to the sun, they were the closest to heaven, they were the darkest because they were sun-kissed. God first created Dinka. And then if you move, as you move from Nuba Mountains in any direction, people get shorter and lighter skin, which turns out is kind of true, right? But then God created Dinka and gave them stewardship over all cows, which means all cow belong to Dinka. So when young men are wrestling through any part, running through and moving through any parts of South Sudan, and they see somebody else in possession of cows, it's actually part of their stewardship responsibility to bring those cows back to Dinka possession. They don't consider it stealing. It's not cattle wrestling. It's actually part of their ontological stewardship and responsibility. Now you can imagine other groups don't have that same story. And so they're confused when people are taking their cows, right? Most of us, when we hear this story, we think that's almost absurd that they would think that they own all of the cows in the world, right? So we would investigate that story. But it's really interesting because that story is an exact same narrative arc as the manifest destiny doctrine of discovery that gave rise to all of the genocidal dispossession of indigenous people all throughout the planet. And it's taken us almost 1,600 years before we were willing to investigate that story. It's also interesting because it's the exact same narrative arc of the story that we tell and celebrate about God giving chosen people a chosen land. Even when the scriptures say the Hittites, the Canaanites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites were in the land, we celebrate their dispossession because somehow there's a way that certain narratives are acceptable and others are not, even though they all have the same narrative arc. So we live inside of stories, and the problem is every story operates as a metaphor. Some of those metaphors, all metaphors have the same character. They reveal things and they hide things.